Hello students, good morning. Welcome back to our science class. Today it is the second class of our third topic, that is fiber to fabric. In previous video we have understood the meaning of yarn, fiber and about natural fibers and artificial fibers. Natural fibers like cotton, wool, silk, flax, all these are the examples of natural fiber, right? Then about animal fibers also we discussed. These all are natural fibers, and man-made fibers are also called as synthetic fibers, which are rayon, nylon, polyester are the examples of synthetic fibers. Now in this class we are going to study in detail about natural plant fibers, that is cotton and jute. Okay, let's start the lesson. Okay students, in this class we will learn and understand few more things. That is, first one is meaning of fabric. Already we know the meaning of fabric, right? In detail we are going to understand in this lesson. Then some plant fibers, cotton and jute. Cotton and jute, about these fibers we are going to learn in detail, their characteristics and their climatic condition in which region cotton and jute are grown. Then we will discuss about spinning of cotton yarn, which can be done through activity. One small activity we are going to do to make a spinning in our home. Then it is detailly we are going to learn about spinning by watching a small video. Yarn to fabric. How yarn is converted into fabric? There are two different methods to convert yarn to fabric: weaving and knitting. Both are done by hands and by machines also. About this in detail we are going to understand today in the class. Then history of clothing. In ancient days how people used to make a fabric, about this also we are going to discuss in today's class. These all are the objectives of the today's class. Okay, are you ready to understand all these points? Let's start. Let's start the topic through a small activity. Activity 3.1. Take out a yarn from a piece of cotton fabric. Place this piece of yarn on the table. Now press one end of the yarn with your thumb. Scratch the other end of the yarn along its length with your nail as shown in the figure 1. Do you find at this end the yarn splits up into thin strands as shown in the figure 2? See here, very simple. Take a piece of cloth, from that take one small yarn. Then you can scratch the yarn. Once the single yarn is splitted into small different thread like structures, right? This single thread is called as yarns. Okay, the yarn split up into thin strands. This is a small fiber. Okay, you might have observed something similar when you try to thread a needle. Many a time the end of the thread is separated into few strands. This makes it difficult to pass the thread through the eye of the needle. The thin strand of the thread that we see are made up of still thinner strand called fibers. When your grandmother or mother used to ask you to thread a needle, that time what happens? You are going to push the thread into the needle's eye, right? But suddenly it splits into different small strands. Then you used to lick it, right? Then you are going to put it into the needle's eye. That thin strands are called as fibers. You can see here. In introduction part you have understood the meaning of fibers, right? Very simple. Thin strands of the yarn is called as fiber. Okay, now we will discuss about fiber to fabric. Before that we will see the meaning of fiber. a material which is available in the form of thin and continuous strand is called fiber. The thin strands of thread that we see are made up of still thinner strands. They are called fibers. The cotton produced by weaving or knitting textile fiber is called fabric. There are two types of fibers. First one is natural fiber. The next one is man-made fiber. It is also called as synthetic fiber. Okay, a material which is available in the form of thin and continuous strand is called as fiber. The thin strands of the thread that we see are made up of still thinner. Once you split the thread, you can see still thinner strands, right? That is called as fibers. There are two types of fibers. First one is natural fiber. Next one is synthetic or man-made fiber. Natural fiber are the fibers which we get by nature. It means by plants or by animals. Today in this class we are going to learn about plant fibers, that is cotton and jute. Cotton. Now we will discuss few more things about cotton. Have you observed while your mother or grandmother making wicks for lamps by pressing it into the arms, right? This is called as wicks for oil lamp. It is done with a cotton. Then it because it absorbs the oil easily so that it can glow brightly. Have you ever made wicks of oil lamps? Try to learn from this your mother to make a wicks. It is very simple and easy method so that once you press the cotton then you will get a wicks. I mean say in the form of fiber. What do you use for the making this? Yes, we use cotton. Cotton is also used for making mattresses, quilts or pillows. It is used to fill the beds and for pillows because it gives very soft and comfort feel. Okay, take some cotton wool and pull it apart. In one hand, take some cotton and pull it apart in the from the other hand. And look at its edges. What do you observe? The small thin strands that you see are made up of cotton fibers. Thin thread will come out from the that cotton ball, right? That is made up of cotton fibers. Where does this cotton come from? Yes, it grows in the plant. It grows in the field. Cotton plants are usually grown at the places having black soil. It requires black soil so that it can grow and get all the nutrients from the soil. And in a warm climate, it needs warm temperature. The fruits of cotton plants are about the size of lemon. After maturing, the balls burst open and the seeds cover with a cotton fibers can be seen. Once the fruit completely grown, it is in the size of lemon. Means when it is fully grown, the size also increases. Then the ball burst open. The seeds covered with the cotton fibers can be seen. Have you ever seen a cotton field that is ready for picking? Yes, it is the cotton field which you can see in the image. It looks like a field covered with snow, completely white and white. When, because all the cotton field is ready for picking the cotton balls. From this cotton ball, cotton is usually picked by hand, right? Fibers are separated from the seeds by combing. This process is called ginning of cotton. What happens? The balls are collected by the hand. It is picked by the hand. Then the small black color seeds from the cotton is separated by combing. This process is called ginning of cotton. Ginning was traditionally done by hand. Nowadays, machines are also used for ginning. Earlier, it used to be done very simple method, just removing the black color seed from the cotton, white color cotton fiber. Earlier, it was done by hand, but nowadays, we need lot of production in less time, right? So, machines are also used for ginning. Let us do one more small activity about the spinning of cotton yarn. Activity number 4. Hold some cotton wool in one hand. Pinch some cotton between the thumb and forefinger of the other hand. Now, gently start pulling out the cotton while continuously twisting the fibers. This process of making yarn from fibers is called as spinning. This activity is very simple. You can do it in your home without anybody's help. Take a pinch of cotton ball in your one hand and pinch some cotton between the thumb and forefinger. You can see in the image. Here hold cotton in this hand with the thumb and forefinger. Pinch the cotton. Then gently start pulling the cotton. Start pulling the cotton from this end by continuously twisting. You will get a thread-like structure. This is a fiber. You have done spinning, right? Very simple activity. You can do it in your home, okay? The process of making yarn from the fiber is called as spinning. In this process, fibers from a mass of cotton wool are drawn outside and twisted. This brings the fiber together to form a yarn. Here you can see a person is pulling out a fiber from the machine. Another simple device used for spinning is hand spindle. You can see the lady is using the hand spindle. Very simple device used to make spinning by the help of hand, and also called thakli. It is also called as thakli. Another hand operated device used for spinning is charaka. You can see in the image Gandhiji used to make his own glass by spinning himself through this charaka. Use of the charaka was popularized by Mahatma Gandhi as a part of independence movement. He encouraged people to wear cloths made of homespun yarn, termed as khadi, and spun imported cloth made in the mills of Britain. To popularize and promote khadi, the government of India constituted a body called Khadi and Village Industries Commission in 1956. Gandhiji was popularized this instrument known as charaka. Okay, spinning is done by hand and machines, right? So by hand, by using a small instrument called as spindle, or by using charaka. But if we need large quantity, spinning of yarn on a large scale is done with the help of spinning machines. After spinning, yarns are used for making fabrics. See, nowadays population is growing very rapidly. For that, we need lot of production, lot of cloths in less time. That's why the spinning is done through a machines. You can see in the images, very large machines are used to make a spinning of yarns. To convert the yarns by the machine, it takes very less time. But large amount of production will be obtained by this. After spinning, these fibers are sent to the next machine, that is called as the machine which converts fiber to fabric. You can see a cotton thread is converted into a cotton cloth. This is the next machine used to make a cotton cloth. We can watch one small video which we can understand more about spinning. Okay, let's have a look on this video.
Spinning cotton yarn. We have variety of things made of cotton. For example, clothes, bed sheets, towels, fishing nets, tents, etc. In order to make these things, we cannot use cotton fibers directly. It is because they does not have required length and strength. We need to convert cotton fibers into yarn. The process of making yarn from cotton fibers is called spinning. You can do it at your home as well. Here is a method. Take some cotton and remove seeds from it. With one hand, pull some fibers from the cotton and twist them continuously. By doing so, fibers come close to each other. They hold each other tightly and we get a long string. The long and strong string obtained by twisting fibers together is cotton yarn. Fabric is made from yarn. We get variety of fabric based on amount of twist in the yarn. For example, low twist makes soft, bulky and velvety fabric, while very high twist makes silky, shiny fabric. In general, average twist is used to make most common fabrics. A simple device used for making yarn is hand spindle. It is also called dakli. A famous hand-operated device is charkha. Mahatma Gandhi popularized it during independence movement. Nowadays, spinning machines are used to produce yarn on large quantity. These machines produce yarn with good quality. Here we complete this topic.
Spinning cotton yarn. We have variety of things made of cotton. For example, clothes, bed sheets, towels, fishing nets, tents, etc. In order to make these things, we cannot use cotton fibers directly. It is because they does not have required length and strength. We need to convert cotton fibers into yarn. The process of making yarn from cotton fibers is called spinning. You can do it at your home as well. Here is a method. Take some cotton and remove seeds from it. With one hand, pull some fibers from the cotton and twist them continuously. By doing so, fibers come close to each other. They hold each other tightly and we get a long string. The long and strong string obtained by twisting fibers together is cotton yarn. Fabric is made from yarn. We get variety of fabric based on amount of twist in the yarn. For example, low twist makes soft, bulky and velvety fabric, while very high twist makes silky, shiny fabric. In general, average twist is used to make most common fabrics. A simple device used for making yarn is hand spindle. It is also called dakli. A famous hand-operated device is charkha. Mahatma Gandhi popularized it during independence movement. Nowadays, spinning machines are used to produce yarn on large quantity. These machines produce yarn with good quality. Here we complete this topic. Visit learnfatafat.com for more such interesting videos. You can now download LearnFatafat Android app. For better learning, you can also buy your favorite course in the form of DVD, pen drive, SD card or tablet phone.
Yes, after spinning, we will discuss about weaving and knitting. There are many ways by which fabrics are made from yarns. The two main processes are weaving and knitting. You can see in the image, this is knitting. The lady is using a needle and a single strand of fabric is used. I mean single thread is used to knit the cloth. Either it can be converted into sweater, socks, scarf, mufflers, anything. Okay, this method is called as knitting. The process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric is called weaving. You can see here two sets of yarns are used. One is vertical set and another one is horizontal. That same thread is passed to right to left. You can see clearly in the image, right? This method is called as weaving. Weaving, later it leads to fabric. Fabric can be converted into different types of cloths of different shapes and size and of different designs. These are the two important processes by which fibers can be converted into fabric.
Okay, let us do one more simple activity which helps us to know more about weaving. Okay, let's try to weave some paper strips. Take two sheets of paper of different colors. You take two opposite color papers sheets so that it looks very beautiful. Now I will explain the method. You try it in your home. Okay. Cut square pieces of length and width equal to 30 cm from each sheet. Now fold both the sheets into half. On one sheet, draw lines as shown in the figure 1 and on the other as shown in figure 2. Cut both the sheets along the dot lines and then unfold. Weave the strips one by one through the cuts in the sheet of paper. In the similar manner, two sets of yarn are wound to make a fabric. The yarn are much thinner than our paper strips. Of course, weaving of fabric is done on looms. The looms are either hand operated or power operated. Once you start doing this activity, you will get the image like this, so that one will be vertical and another color you can see in the horizontal way you have waved it. Finally, it looks like a piece of cloth or it looks like a mat, right? In the same way, the fibers, yarns are used to weave into a fabric. Hope you understand this activity. Okay, now let us see about knitting. I think you have observed your grandmothers or any neighbors or your mothers used to knit a sweater or socks for you or newly born baby, right? Yes, that process is known as knitting. Have you ever noticed how sweaters are knitted? In knitting, a single yarn is used to make a piece of fabric, whereas in weaving, two different fabrics were used. One is on the horizontal line and another as a vertical, right? Here, one single yarn is used to knit a whole cloth. Have you ever pulled the yarn off from the torn pair of socks? What happens? Single yarn gets pulled out continuously as the fabric gets unraveled. Socks and many other clothing items are made of knitting fabrics. Knitting is done by hand and also on machines. Weaving and knitting are used for making different kinds of fabric. These fabrics are used for a variety of clothing items. Okay, you might have done, everyone has done this, I hope. If you have a small hole on your socks, you used to pull the thread, right? Once you start pulling the thread, you can see a fiber coming continuously from the socks, right? That is, a single fiber is used to make a sweater or socks or scarf. Mufflers are done by using a single fiber, and this method is known as knitting. You can see here single thread is used and two different needles are used to make a design, right? This is called as knitting. Next, coming to the one more plant fiber, that is jute. Jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. It is cultivated during the rainy season. In India, jute is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. The jute plant is normally harvested when it is as
at the flowering stage. The stem of the harvested plants are immersed in the water for a few days. The stems rot and the fibers are separated by hand. In this picture you can see jute plants, right? These are grown mainly in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. Okay, what happens during the flowering stage, these jutes are cut, then they make it into a bundle and thrown in a river. After few days the stem completely rots and it converts into a fiber. The all fleshy part will be rot and you can get the fiber. That fiber is kept it for the drying under the sun. Later those ropes are used. You can see drying of jute fiber, black colored fiber from conventional method of retting. The process of submersion of jute fiber is called in water is called as retting. Lustrous golden color fiber from improved method of retting. Jute is a golden color fiber which is very rough, so we don't use jute to make a cloth, right? What happens, it is a stem part of the plant, so it is important to remember jute is the stem part of a plant. Once it enters the stage of flowering, the plant stems are cut and it is kept in a water for many days and all the fleshy part becomes rot, then it is kept for drying. Later the black colored fiber from the conventional method of retting is taken, then it once it completely dries, it becomes a golden color, very hard fiber you will get from the jute plant. Jute is not used to make a cloth, right? But it is used in various ways. Hope all of you have seen such bags. These bags are called as gunny bags. To store all the grains, gunny bags are used, which are made up of jute and ropes and some fancy items like doll, then bags, jewelries, slippers, bags, then some furnitures, then kitchenwares, all these are done with the help of jute. These are the various uses of jute. Still now we discussed about plant fiber, that is cotton and jute and their applications, right? Now let us have a look on history of clothing materials. What happens in earlier days, which type of cloth they used to wear? There was there a cotton or jute or silk? Let us see. Have you ever wondered what matters people used in ancient times for clothing? It appears that in those times people used the bark of big leaves for trees or animal skin and furs to cover themselves. They use big leaves to cover their body, or they use animal skin to protect themselves, or animal furs are also used to cover their body. This was the ancient time. They used the plant and animal, but not in a fabric way. Directly they use tree barks or big leaves or animal skin and furs to cover their body. After people began to settle in agricultural communities, they learned to weave twigs and grasses into mats and baskets. Vines, animals, fleas or hair were twisted together into long strands. These were worn into fabrics. They used to collect fleas or hair from the animals or long twigs or grasses. Later, both are twisted together to make a long strand, which is the rough idea of making fibers. Then they used to wear it in the form of dress into fabrics. The early Indians who wore fabric made out of cotton that grew in the regions near the river Ganga. Flax is also a plant that gives natural fibers. In ancient Egypt, cotton as well as flax were cultivated near the river
nile and were used for making fabrics. In ancient time, Indians used to grow cotton and flax near the river Ganga, whereas in ancient Egypt, cotton as well as flax were cultivated near the river Nile. Later, they used to make it into a long strands and converted into a fabrics. These are the rough ideas about fabrics, so that they can make a cloth for themselves to protect their body at during different weather. As we saw in the previous slide, in those days they were not that much familiar about stitching, right? Stitching was not known. People simply wrapped the fabric around a different part of their body. Many different ways of wrapping fabric were used. With the invention of the sewing needle, people started stitching fabrics to make cloths. Stitched cloths have gone through many variations since this invention. But it is not amazing that even today sari, dhoti and lungi or turban is used as an unstitched piece of fabric. Earlier there were needle was not invented, right? They were not familiar with sewing. Once the needle was invented, sewing has taken tremendous changes. We can get 1000 types of different varieties of dresses now. Stitched dresses, right? Till today we are wearing unstitched dress in the form of sari, lungi and dhoti. Even turbans are also called as unstitched piece of fabric. Just as there is a large variety in food eaten all over our country, a large variety exists also in the fabrics and clothing item. As we discussed in the second lesson, different part of the country people eat different types of food. In the same way, it applicable in the fabric also. Based on the climatic condition, people wear different types of cloths. Okay, still now we discussed about the cotton fiber, how yarns are converted into fabric, that weaving and knitting are the different methods used to convert yarn into fabric, right? Now we will discuss about the characteristics of cotton. All of you are familiar with these all different types of cotton dresses, right? You might have experienced it. The positive characteristics of cotton are: it absorbs moisture, means it absorbs water. So we used to wear in summer. It absorbs sweat from our body and it keeps cool in hot weather. That's why in summer we used to wear cotton light colored dresses, which helps to absorb the moisture and keeps our body cool in hot weather. Then it is very easy to launder, means very easy to wash. No need to do any dry clean. We can wash it in a cold water in home or by machine or by hand. Negative things of cotton are: wrinkles easily. After every wash, you need to iron it. If not, it wrinkles easily and it looks very dull. So you need to press, it looks very neat. It shrinks easily. The cotton fiber shrinks easily. So it is the negative thing of cotton. If not remaining, we feel very comfortable to wear it, cotton dresses and cotton sarees, which keeps us very comfortable and makes you look very smart. Okay students, till now we discussed about the characteristics and uses of cotton and jute fiber, right? Now we will discuss about the differences between cotton and jute. Most of the characteristics are completely different, right? But one common thing is both obtained from the plant. Both are natural fibers. First, cotton. Cotton is the fruit part of a cotton plant. Cotton obtained from the fruit part of a plant, whereas jute is the stem part of a jute plant. The stem part of the jute plant is collected and it is soaked in the water. Later the fiber is collected from the jute. It is stem part.
It is in white color, whereas jute appears in golden yellow. Cotton is soft and comfortable to make fabric. Cotton is very soft. You might have tested it, right? It is very soft. That's why it is used to make a cotton cloth, which is very comfortable to wear in hot weather, hot climate. During summer, we usually wear cotton dresses. Whereas jute is very hard. Its texture is very hard, so it is cannot used to make a fabric. Have you ever seen jute frock or jute pant shorts or saris? No, because it is very hard. We won't feel comfortable to wear hard fabrics, right? That's why jute is used to make other things, other objects like gunny bags, doormats, then ropes, etc. Cotton requires more than 21 degrees Celsius of temperature. It requires more than 21 degrees Celsius of temperature, whereas jute requires 30 degrees Celsius of temperature. Jute need more temperature than the cotton. Cotton grows in loamy and black soil. Loamy soil and black soil, because it holds more water. That's why cotton grows in loamy soil. Whereas jute also grows in loamy soil, which is well-drained. Well-drained, fertile, loamy soil is required for the growth of jute plant. This is similar. Both the fibers, plants are grown in loamy soil. Rainfall. To grow the cotton, at least from 50 to 100 centimeter rainfall should be there in that area. It requires 50 to 100 centimeter rainfall. Whereas for the jute, it requires near about 150 centimeters of rain. Jute requires more rain than the cotton. Cotton mainly grown in Maharashtra and Gujarat, whereas jute is grown in eastern states of the country. These all are the differences between cotton and jute, but some similarities are there. Both of them grow in loamy soil. Both require fertile soil and loamy soil. Both are the parts of the plant. Both are natural fibers. These are the similarities. Okay. Okay students, now this is the time to summarize the topic. Okay, today in this class we have learned these all points. Let us see one by one. There is a variety of clothing material or fabric such as cotton, silk, wool and polyester. Next, fabrics are made from yarns, which in turn are made from fibers. Fibers are either natural or synthetic. Cotton, wool, silk and jute are some natural fibers, while nylon, rayon and polyester are some examples of synthetic fibers. Yes, we have discussed about this. Some of them are natural fibers which we obtain from the plant and animal are called as natural fibers, and some fibers which are made by man by using the chemicals are called as synthetic fibers or man-made or artificial fibers, right? For artificial fibers, nylon, rayon and polyester are the examples. Next, fibers like cotton and jute are obtained from plants. The process of making yarns from fiber is called spinning. Fabric from yarn is made by weaving or knitting. About these all points we have discussed today. Hope you understand the topic, right? Have a nice day. Bye.